Hello, everybody, and welcome in. It is 8 o'clock, and that's a happy hour for us. It's going to be a happy three and maybe even more. This is the sixth annual Superstars Reborn, presented to you exclusively by Superstardom. It's all non-created tonight, but don't be surprised as the Superstars put their creativity to their minds and come up with some amazing matches. We have eight on tap for you tonight, three championship matches, and two more rounds of the Superstardom Draft. If you missed the pre-show, you missed the first three rounds of the Superstardom Draft, as well as a pre-show match between Headshot Killa and Nexus Genesis, that of which Headshot won in a very entertaining but quick bout. This next one may be as quick, if not quicker, or could be longer. Who knows? But one other thing that they don't know is the characters they'll represent. Kicking this show off is Tyron Hunt versus Wicked Junior, and it is a second round Superstars exclusive match tonight. This will be the only match that these superstars are using their characters that they are selected in for the second round. Now, I should kind of put a disclaimer at that because there are some superstars that are competing tonight that picked the same characters for the second half as what they had for the first half. Case in point, DZ and NBC in our Hell in a Cell main event. Let's go to round number four here. And it's going to start out with the current United States champion at number 30, Jumper V Magnum. Jumper Magnum shocked the world as Baron Corbin, and we are going to see if he can keep the championship with Baron Corbin. But if he does win or lose, he will be traveling to the Isle of Samoa, because Jumper Magnum is Samoa Joe. Next is B-Money. B-Money, the Savage, Trippy Thugger, whatever you want to call him, going from Titus O'Neil to Kevin Owens. A big upgrade for him. Next, oh man, big name after big name. How about James R. Coffle? James R. Coffle is somebody who does not know who he will be next half. He has a match tonight as John Cena. But after this, he will be the man that gravity forgot, Neville. And next, it is Tyron Hunt. Tyron Hunt will be using the superstar we were about to mention in this upcoming matchup to kick off the show. Tyron Hunt was The Miz. He is now the Celtic Warrior, Sheamus. Following that, Kratos God. A part-time superstar who was Big Show is now going into the cosmos with Stardust. Nexus Genesis is up at number 36. And Nexus is now done using Adam Rose. And instead of being the Party Express, he's going to be the Bulgarian Brute, Rusev. And the last superstar for round number four, Tyron Hunt's opponent, Wicked Jr. Wicked Jr. was graced with some very good characters in the first half. He probably will not think so with this half. However, this superstar was still successful under Jumper Magnum. Wicked will trade spots with the U.S. champion and become the lone wolf, Baron Corbin. And so that is our first match. Let's go ahead and make it Baron Corbin versus Sheamus to kick things off on Superstars Reborn. The match is up. We ask that those competitors join, and Ratluck, of course, will be watching with me. Ratluck, our cameraman for the majority of the night here on Superstars Reborn. Going to be an exciting night. Roman Reigns, a character we thought we would be seeing following this with Frost. However, we've learned earlier this evening, Frost will be unable to make tonight's show. And so Frost actually being replaced in his triple threat match tonight, he originally scheduled to go up with Tripod and Beatdown. Hybrid Maniac will join that match, so we'll get to see a little bit of Y2J, and Hybrid's good friend Ratluck will represent him following tonight, as we await now for Wicked Jr. to join the fray. Again, Tyron Hunt and Wicked Jr., an opportunity for both of these guys, that are, of course, probably in maybe the right place at the right time right now, because it's that time of the year coming up. We've got a pay-per-view collision course surrounded around people that have never won the main event championship, and these superstars have won neither of the two big main event titles, so it'll be interesting to see what occurs there. Wicked Jr. is now made his presence felt. And don't forget, guys, any superstar that is drafted tonight, that can always be changed via trades, which Wicked may end up looking into, or could he find his niche with Baron Corbin, as well as other ways of acquiring things through free agent picks, title shots, draft picks, and more through other ways of accessibility. Don't forget in-ring entrances for tonight. All the matches except for our big three matches tonight, which are all championship matches. Those matches and those competitors competing in them will receive entrances. But it is time to get the official pay-per-view on the road. Not so laughter. Sometimes you'll hear me get out of character to talk with people. Of course, we've got the production truck chocked full. Ralik, our head cameraman, Hybrid Maniac, media ambassador, COO Brutality in the back. A lot of people trying to make sure things go right tonight as we are awaiting to launch into this opening matchup on the main card. We'll have Ralik get in the ring, ladies first, or gingers in this case. No offense to those that are of gender descent. And the following contest is our opening match of the evening and is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first in the top left corner from Wisconsin, representing Baron Corbin, Wicked Junior. And his opponent standing across the ring from him, representing Sheamus from Houston, Texas. This is Tyron Hart. All right, guys, ready? Ding, ding, ding. And we are underway. Superstars Reborn starts out with a belly-to-belly in favor of Wicked. The reversals, however, are not in favor of him. Tyron Hart was used to having to conserve his reversals, having just three with The Miz. He now has four, so he's hoping that will help his case. And a belly-to-belly to return. Turn the favor from Tyron, this time going towards Wicked Jr. Oh, I just realized I didn't get myself counted out. Botch. We'll re-ring the bell. Oh my goodness. This pay-per-view, hey, it's already off to a good start. I got a little too excited. I was excited. You know, the Superstardom draft, you got it all Superstardom pay-per-view. It's a little easier with the connection. I got a little ahead of myself. My apologies. We were at a pretty neutral stalemate, though, between you two at that time. Ding, ding, ding. And so the second part of this now, best of two, is underway. So Sheamus and Baron Corbin, two fairly big guys, I would say, both in the height and obviously bulky guys here. So two big men kicking off the show, trying to put an entertaining match on. Tyron Hunt with the comfortable upper hand early on. And this has got to be such a relieving feeling for Tyron to have a character like Sheamus, a guy who obviously you're going to feel a lot more comfortable with than you did with The Miz. These characters, though, you know, each one of them with some flaws. Tyron Hunt, if you look in terms of a multi-man match, he's going to need to make sure he's hitting that bro kick in multi-mans, because he's not going to find a lot of success with a move like the Pale of Justice. Wicked Jr.'s end of day is a little quicker. I think it's doable that he could win multi-mans. We've seen Jumper do it with Baron Corbin. And that's one thing Wicked needs to do to keep himself positive in a moment where he's clearly not feeling as positive right now. But you have to look at it. What big stuff? All right, never mind. Anyway, Tyron Hunt in the upper hand. Fireman's carry connects for Wicked Jr. Tyron Hunt with a backbreaker. We'll figure it out. We got it. Backbreaker delivered to Wicked Jr. Tyron Hunt, stomp on the chest of Wicked Jr. And now Tyron grappling towards that chin or that neck area of Wicked. Looks like he's trying to untwist his head off. Tyron Hunt with a much more methodical pace to him tonight than what we had seen as The Miz. And Wicked Jr. looking pretty lifeless, but he's got to be careful as he's power slammed down Tyron with a signature. And when's the last time you've seen Wicked this one-sided? And more importantly, when's the last time you've seen Tyron Hunt this good? By the way, I want to remind everybody, we'll actually be seeing Sheamus and Baron Corbin twice tonight. They're going to be represented again. Tyron Hunt's character being represented by Killer Pack. Wicked Junior's Baron Corbin being represented by Jumper Magnum still. So these two, if you like these guys, if you like big men, you'll get a double dose of them as Wicked's going to take a walk around the outside. You can see our ring apron, Hell in a Cell. The main event of tonight, DZ defending his coveted undisputed Superstardom Championship against NBC Master and James R. Coffle in the unforgiving Hell in a Cell structure. And now Wicked, as soon as he comes back in, he walks right into a scoop slam. Tyron Hunt green barring Wicked Jr. and another knee to that chest. Jumper Magnum found the winning formula with Baron Corbin. Wicked Jr. still looking to find that, but he's got to be careful with these reversals. He's now down to just one, and Tyron Hunt using that reversal. Scoop, slam, connect. There's going to be a more strategic game needed. Tyron Hunt, calm down on that knee. Wicked Jr. brought back up into that chin lock from Tyron Hunt. We got to see an alternative angle. Now you're seeing the face of Wicked in agony right now. Tyron Hunt comfortable right now in this matchup. But Wicked has got to show some fight back. Far from over yet, though. And now Tyron, the backbreaker. Wicked getting his second reversal back. And Wicked always, and one thing I've noticed early on, this is a smart move on Wicked Jr.'s end. He's always making sure he's at least got that one reversal. You reverse that finisher, that changes everything. And Tyron Hunt's going to have to commit to attempting to use a finisher while Wicked Jr. still has a reversal, unless Wicked goes early. Wicked continuing, though, as soon as he gets his offense back, Tyron uses a reversal. Now Wicked using a reversal. And Wicked, on the rope, clothesline. I think he caught Tyron by surprise. Stomp onto the ribs. Wicked's going to have to be careful with that. No reversal. Another stomp. But he's doing a good job of taking a slow time right now with Tyron Hunt. And this could be it. No, Tyron with the bro kick, and it caught in the back of Wicked Jr. That's eligible to be pinned off of 1, 2, and Tyron Hunt not just yet. Wicked Jr. staying out of it, and perhaps that's perhaps Tyron just didn't get the full extent of that bro kick. Certainly looked obvious to me that he didn't, and that might have been why Wicked was able to stay alive, but for how much longer? Tyron already back with a signature after that headbutt to the side of Wicked's head. Wicked Jr. picked up by Tyron. Wicked with a reversal out of him again. And Wicked with the right hand. Another right uppercut. This time it misses. And now dragging Tyron towards the center of the ring, throwing him, and Wicked getting a little bit, some rare moments of offense. And again, you can see Wicked being conservative in his time. Throwing the head back of Tyron Hunt. No taunts being used. I stand corrected. One taunt being used by Wicked Jr. That certainly is going to help his momentum case. Tyron able to grapple Wicked as he botched the clothesline. It looked like it might have been. Now a back suplex connects for Tyron, and the referee getting caught. You never know what he'll decide to do. Tyron Hunt with a gut-wrench suplex. Signature in hand for Tyron. He's still in yellow, but he's... Wicked has calculatingly been doing some more damage to Tyron Hunt, who looks like he's about to obtain his second finisher of the night. Wicked Jr. getting his second reversal back just now. Tyron up 1-0 in the finisher count. Snap mare and off the rope. Here comes Tyron, the boot to the side of the face of Wicked Jr. And Tyron with his first taunt. Tyron now picking up the Lone Wolf's new representative. Wicked using a reversal to throw Tyron onto the apron. And a right hand, and Tyron goes to the outside just as Wicked had done. Wicked with his second taunt, and Wicked will have a signature. It's going to take an underdog performance for Wicked Jr. in this matchup. The referee, the count of two, Tyron Hunt. He was thrown to the outside. Can lose off of count out. Will not be a factor in our main events stipulation, but it is in this and many of our matches tonight. Again, stockpiling. Big number of matches tonight. Tyron at the midway point of the count. 6, and Tyron will get in the ring. And Wicked able to capitalize. No clean entry. Belly to belly given. Stomp on the ribs. Tyron Hunt, though, filled it. 4 reversals. He uses one off. Wicked running away. And, oh, Wicked gets his head taken off with the bro kick. I think Wicked ducked a little too early. 1, 2, and that will do it. The referee referee with a little bit of hang time there. And Tyron Hunt as the Celtic Warrior. I think he's happy with his upgrade. And he's going to be happy with the result of that match. Because we had mentioned before this match started, with Collision Course coming up, we will see challengers that have never before won the World Championship thrusted into a main event role. And after a win tonight, Tyron Hunt has earned himself just that. Tyron Hunt will compete for the Undisputed World Championship over on ED Saturday, June 11th, 4 weeks from today, at EIF's Collision Course pay-per-view event. It's the sixth annual Collision Course, and it will be the opportunity for Tyron to get his first ever main event championship. But a win for the Celtic Warriors' newest representative kicks off this show. And Wicked looked like he was learning to play as Baron Corbin more as the match went on, learning to adapt a little bit more. He got a signature, was taking a little bit of the offense, and I think Wicked was actually going to get that upper hand. He ducks a little early, maybe charging towards that grapple, looked like it might have been a running grapple. And Tyron catching Wicked with his head down and absolutely teed off on it with the bro kick. Referee was looking like he even felt bad for Wicked. He tried to give him a couple of extra seconds. But Wicked Jr. unable to kick out here and drops the opening contest of tonight. We are now preparing for our next matchup here tonight. And it looks like we might actually get to see Baron Corbin in back-to-back matches, as we could be heading to our first championship match of the evening here tonight. First of three. So the U.S. champion, Jumper Magnum, entering the party, as is his opponent, Untamed. Jumper and Untamed, and we're going to go ahead and get set here. Of course, this being the fact that it is one of our three championship matches, it is going to feature entrances for tonight. And so this will be an interesting one again. Jumper Magnum, let's talk about how we got here. Jumper Magnum with a near two-month United States title reign versus Untamed Legend tonight. Untamed Legend, not a historically well-known superstardom guy. That might change as he's acquired John Cena's rights. But what's also interesting is how they got here, because in a four-man over-the-top battle royale, Frost and Evams ended up being the forgotten ones in the match, while instead we ended up seeing Jumper and Untamed Legend continue to duke it out. Back and forth they went. Numerous opportunities for each superstar to eliminate the other. And ultimately, it ended up favoring Jumper v. Magnum just by a hair, able to throw Untamed Legend over the top rope and out. And so now, Untamed believes that had it not been, and I should mention Untamed had several more elimination attempts on Jumper than Jumper had on him, had it not been for that count, Untamed believes we would maybe be seeing a different story, perhaps. And because of that, he believes that there should be a new United States champion. So we're going to get to hopefully find that out in just a few moments here. Thank you. Kevin Condos is scheduled for one fall. This is for the United States Championship. Representing Billy Gunn, Untamed Legend. I apologize if some of that was a little off cue here, but we had a slight party issue, so I didn't get to hear when my cue was. I missed that. But either way, Untamed Legend again looking for his first title on the brand of Superstardom, and what better of a place to do it than Superstars Reborn, where he'll have an opportunity to beat his opponent, the two-month reigning champion. And now, introducing his opponent from Sydney, Australia, representing the Lone Wolf, Baron Corbin. He is the current reigning and defending EIF United States Champion, Jumper B. It has been an unlikely road that has led Jumper to this point. A few days away from a two-month mark on a reign that started with him beating a superstar who had five reversals and continued watching him defend with a superstar that had three. It is an unlikely scenario and an unlikely superstar, the first and only Australian-born EIF superstar to have ever won a championship. And now, he will not look to be losing that title anytime soon. Untamed Legend is going to try and pose him the challenge. Untamed, much like Tyron Hunt we just saw in our last match, has that 4-3 reversal advantage over Baron Corbin. Wicked Jr. didn't do a good job of representing that character, but it might be a different feeling for Jumper Magnum. Obviously, he's much more comfortable as Baron Corbin. He's upgrading to Samoa Joe after this match. Up, but he's got one last stand, and it is for the United States Championship, as just mentioned on your screen a couple of moments ago, or a few seconds ago. The title being raised to remind these superstars the implications of this matchup. It has been a while since Untamed has been in a true opportunity to win a championship, so you know how much this means for a guy like him. But again, this is the only thing Jumper has known in EIF, this United States Championship. It is not something he wants to let go of, as he will be forced to hand the title over to our official for this matchup. This match can be won by pinfall, submission, as well as count out and disqualification, and if need be, the 7 finisher count mercy rule. As our entrances wrap up, we begin to make this match online now, and we'll ask our superstars to manually join by profile. And again, this is our first of three championship matches, and the match is up. Again, Jumper Magnum, the United States Championship of 2 months, defended by Jumper Magnum against Untamed Legend. Our second match of the pay-per-view. Third overall, if you guys count the kickoff show. That's always a tough one for me to decide between, because some people, when I say it's the opening contest when I was doing Tyron Hunt and Wicked Jr., people are like, it's technically not. But it really depends on how you guys look at it. Either way, though, it was a very entertaining one. Somewhat quick as we saw in our first match, it'll be interesting to see if this one continues that trend or if we'll see these guys go a little bit more to the distance. So we move on here. Already around the 20 viewer mark. Glad you could join us tonight. Our 6th annual Superstars Reborn pay-per-view event. Jumper and Untamed already know the characters they'll represent. If this was tomorrow, it would be Samoa Joe versus John Cena. That would be interesting. We still have one more round of Superstardom Draft that'll be coming up again at some point here tonight. Couple of names that are still known in EIF that have not came off the board, and certainly a plethora of characters that have not as well. Ratluck gets in early. I tell him to get out. That's right, get out. I'm the leader of the Nation of Domination. Untamed Legend, hopefully in a freak grapple accident, nothing will come of that. For those of you that don't know, this is going to be a tough match to communicate with Untamed Legend for. Reason being, Untamed Legend has actually had a mic ban on Xbox. I have not been told the reason why, but something tells me there's something I cannot say over here. Well, the network. Bat Luck spawning in the ring again. He's going to be getting counted out. I saw that. All right, so the entrances are not needed in ring because they were already announced. Here we go, guys. No, jumper back up. No, okay, just go. Untamed can't talk, so that kind of, you know, you have to wait for the bell, man, because he has no idea. He can't talk or hear on Xbox. So either way, power slam connects for Jumper Magnum. This United States title match prematurely underway. And Jumper to the offense early. Untamed quick to use a reversal, his first of the match. Both are already one reversal in. Now Untamed with a fall-away slam delivered. Jumper Magnum stomped in the stomach. Untamed Legend again with a stomp. So one thing we've seen about Jumper in his U.S. title reign, he's typically a slow-paced superstar. That kind of complements what Baron Corbin truly is. So we'll see if Untamed Legend will share that philosophy, or if Untamed is going to look to speed up a little bit. Ralluck left the session unintentionally, but this match does continue. Ralluck was a... wait a minute. Ralluck, I hope you can't see it. Shit. All right, guys, the match is off right now. Ralluck, are you there? Jumper, the match is going to be like restarting or something. All right. Fucking A. All right, guys, so sorry about that. Obviously, a bit of a technical difficulty occurred there. We had a disconnect with Ralluck being our head cameraman. That kind of affects things because, obviously, we want you, our audience, to be able to see this matchup going on. Fortunately, it was early enough that we were able to stop the match, and we'll restart it here, so the match is yet again up. We'll ask everybody to rejoin here. So Untamed Legend will... Oh, Untamed is here. Okay. As I had said, a little bit harder to communicate with Untamed Legend just given that all this stuff is going on right now, but hopefully it all works out. Another superstar who is not scheduled to be on the card tonight has just gotten on, EIF Greedy. Very, obviously, very well-known superstar. He, too, experienced his first main event success here on the brand of Superstardom. So, you know, just going back to, you know, what we had talked about during the pre-show, myself, Ralluck, and Brutality about the development, the furtherment of this of this brand as a whole and all the superstars that have represented it. Obviously, Jumper Magnum's career is coming around quite well here on Superstardom. He's actually a primary-based Superstardom character. So we get set here. Immediately, the bell to stall. This time, I will get in the ring first. Scream a little bit as Roman. And of course, after this, we will ring the bell. Jumper, I will ask you to stand still until you hear me ring the bell. One taunt for Jumper Magnum. He just continues to upset me. Tyron Hunt unnecessarily in the party, laughing afterward. Now, Rat Luck. Tyron, are you even watching the network? Thank you. He's getting shout-outs on the network. And by the way, guys, if you haven't done so already, make sure you follow us here on EIF Network. We give shout-outs throughout the night to new followers, not old followers that refollow just to get a shout-out. I don't like when you do that. But either way, again, if you're new to the EIF Network, make sure you follow us. You might hear your name right here on the broadcast. And if you're new to EIF, hey, I had a couple of guys that were new that I just talked to today. They're going to get to hear their names and the characters they'll represent. All right, guys. Ding, 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 ding. Jumper makes movement, it's Untamed's turn, and Untamed getting caught. Belly to belly connects for Jumper Magnum, and this United States title match, yet again, is underway. A couple of stomps in on the chest of Untamed Legend. I'm seeing a little bit more of that choppy style connection that I didn't see right away in the last portion of our matchup. Jumper, again, being from Australia, that can take an effect as he uses a reversal, not a ring escape, to exit the ring. Untamed Legend, though, is trying to adapt to the connection issues, and he's adapting quite well. Early on, he has the offense. Jumper Magnum down to one reversal. And Untamed getting that quick start. Jumper Magnum perched on the top turnbuckle. And now we wait. And Jumper misses wildly. So both men with a stare down. Untamed Legend off to a very good start. Untamed stomping away here. Now knee thrown on, and a little bit of lag, as I had mentioned. It's seeming to calm down a bit, though. Untamed Legend throwing Jumper across the ring there. And Jumper down, Jumper now stopping, coming back in. And we did see somewhat lag like this also when Jumper fought Ebams, but Jumper is not doing himself a favor by exiting that much. Early in a match like this, and here we go, that's a ring escape. Well, Untamed Legend seems to have been experienced in the lag factor. And Jumper now begin to have some issues with the lag, but to be fair, he is the one that is the furthest away, and Jumper had, we have seen delay in Jumper's kitchen in the past. So Jumper has got to be, he can lose the championship off a ring out. This is WWE rules. It is a WWE. We do not let the championship count out. Count it. Five, Jumper entry from Untamed. Seven, and now Untamed in slow motion, power slammed down. Be trying to keep a heavy eye on this man, almost presentation than a match, hoping that it will settle down point here. Australia, that can happen. We're expecting it not to happen after this inside North America. I say North America and not the United States because we have both Beatdown and Pepsi scheduled to compete tonight. There are rumors going around right now that Pepsi will join the list of Super Bowl to make it. Jumper now in the offense despite the lag. And Jumper Magnum, this odd camera angle for him. And now, and again, I say this, the Jumper actually did a taunt prior to the bell, which we don't necessarily have a rule. We call it an A, and it doesn't result in an act of the other superstar. So Jumper Magnum rolled Untamed over onto his back. You have to have a feeling that just like the Headshot and Nexus Genesis match that kicked off our pre-show, you have to have a feeling that this match is going to end off one finish based off the lag. Jumper Magnum scoops, or a power slam rather, excuse me. Untamed Legend pulled back down. And so the lag, which initially had favored Untamed Legend, Jumper has done a good job of battling back. And one of the reasons why this match could be laggy is Brutality, as just mentioned. Untamed Legend on the, or is on the EIF network. So that's obviously one of those prerequisites we ask our superstars not to do. Unless he's on the mobile version. I've seen people do that. That typically doesn't result in too much bad. But now Untamed Legend able to respond. And now Untamed, let's see what he does here. Slow motion for me. We love that song. Classic First Life. As he throws Jumper down, that's perhaps the slowest we've seen this whole match. So now as it slows down, Untamed certainly taking the upper hand. Just a miserable connection matchup. I apologize to our viewers as well as the competitors here. I'm not sure why it is so bad. Jumper Magnum with a belly to belly, and it's skipping a little bit. You have a couple of seconds of decentness, and then you have the rest choppy. I think it could be that AI fan in the crowd that was just checking his cell phone connection. He also realizes we have no service in this area. Now we're attempting to restore the connection. You know, I will say in Jumper's matches, I don't think I've seen the lag get this bad. These guys also fought, keep in mind, with both Frost and Ebams in a four-man. They had myself and somebody else watching too, so there were six connections in that match as opposed to the four in this, including myself and Ratlux. That match wasn't streamed, I don't think, or it might have been. I don't know. I can't remember now. You have to think this match is probably one more attempting to restore the connection away from possibly disconnecting the whole thing. And Untamed Legend with a little bit of sign language here. He's saying the lag is not going to stop him. Two taunts. Slow crotch chops. I guess that's putting an emphasis on them. Untamed Legend with a neck breaker connecting. God, you know, the referee had that hang time count on the Tyron Wicked Jr. match. Gotta wonder the hang time that's going to be on this match. Four taunts for Untamed Legend. All right, so Untamed is down to one taunt, and he also has a signature. Anyway, you slice this, somebody is going to probably lose a match that they're going to want back. You never know. We could end up seeing a rematch of this. Jumper Magnum slowly falling to the ground and then being pancaked to that canvas based on the way the lag is making it appear. And then you have this. These, like, 5 seconds or so where it does look like it's bad, and then it comes back. And you got to wonder who this is. Is it Untamed? Is it Jumper? Is it a combination? You know, is it Ralluk? Is it us being on the network? You know, and all we can really say, folks, is, you know, we're sorry. We're not intending for this to happen. It's tough. Either way, though, this is a match for a championship, and Untamed Legend may be looking to win perhaps the worst United States Championship match. He's going to hit the finisher. I can already tell. Yep, there it is. All right, the finisher has been hit. Jumper Magnum's Brew, I don't know. All right, we're going to have to talk with Brutality. I'm not saying it because Jumper lost, because obviously the match. I mean... Brew, if you're listening on the network, we'll need your word here. I mean, we could always try it one more time, and if it doesn't work, I mean, I just don't know. It would be a multi-man jumper, probably. All we need to know right now is if that's okay with you. That's all we need to know. Alright, it's even your mic's messing up. So, alright, guys. So, to the disappointment of maybe some, this is going to stand Untamed Legend. Congratulations on becoming the new United States champion. It was obviously a very laggy match, but because we didn't really say anything until the end, it's a little understandable. Very unfortunate there, guys, and obviously, hey, things happen. You know, we're all human here, and clearly Twitch is filled with pros as it is plagued with cons, and so this is just one of the many that you'd see if you've been watching the EIF Network since its inaugural debut. It seems like it sometimes just gets worse, but either way, moving on here. All right, and so coming up next, after our first title changed hands, we still have two more. They will be coming later on this evening, but up next, it will be a battle of characters that are almost identical. Sin Cara versus Kalisto, Big Steph, and he has a big challenge. He'll be going one-on-one with Aaron as we try to get Aaron in the party. No, I wasn't planning on it. All right. Well, anyway, though, guys, I've been told that I should do this. So, Jumper Magnum, unfortunately, losing his United States Championship, which now will be represented by John Cena, because that is Untamed's new character. But even more to the point, though, which will be important, obviously, is that Jumper Magnum, in order to compensate for him, unfortunately losing the match in the way that he did, and in the fact that, you know, there was a lot of lag surrounding it, Jumper has been very impressive. And because of that, Jumper is going to be rewarded. So Tyron Hunt is one of the challengers for the ED's Undisputed World Championship at Collision Course, one of the challengers that never went on to win that title. And so now we'll see the same reward be given to Jumper Magnum. So Jumper Magnum will get to face off with multiple other superstars in hopes of being the first international world champion in EIF. Beatdown, I guess, is the only other one, but he would be the second one, and still obviously the first Australian-born superstar to do that, the first superstar outside of North America to be able to win the Superstar Championship. Jumper will be posed with that option 4 weeks from today at EIF Collision Course. Moving on, as I said, let's talk about the Sin Cara and Kalisto matchup. Appears that nobody in the EIF party listened to my word about trying to get Aaron in here. Thank you. And so I'll go ahead and do it myself. Aaron and Big Steph getting set to go one-on-one. And, you know, for Aaron, this could be looked at as a plug match. For Big Steph, this is certainly not. Steph really trying to show his worth here in EIF and show that he can become a top-level competitor. He's got to do that by getting through Aaron, a guy who's been very successful at the mid-card and also a former one-time undisputed world champion. So let's go ahead. We're going to make that match. Ratluck will be staying with us here, but following this matchup, we will be taking a quick break from the stream, and then we have our first of two multi-mans tonight. But for now, the match is up. We ask our competitors to join again, Kalisto and Sin Cara, Aaron and Big Steph.
No, you did it wrong. It's, ooh, look, open game session. Not only that, but a guy that no one really likes.
And don't forget, guys, that Superstardom Championship match that will be featuring Jumper Magnum will also be featuring Jumper Magnum as Samoa Joe. And of course, tonight is the last time either of these superstars are being represented by the characters that you see on your screen. Aaron had a draft pick and elected to pick The Rock. And Big Steph, it was announced earlier, will be Batista. Also, I want to let people know, just for the sake of what happened. Originally, this match was scheduled as such. However, we got word that Aaron would maybe not have been able to make it tonight due to some emergency issues. And so Animosity was brought in as the call-up. However, Animosity, for now, it looks like will not be needed tonight, but there is still a chance. So, Ant, if you're listening out there, hang tight if you have a chance. Obviously, if you don't want to, completely understand. But there could be an opening. As we said, there is the rumor that Pepsi Killer, rumor been going around that he will be unable to attend tonight. We'll get more details on that for you when they come up. Early on, while I don't want to jinx it, this match looking to be in a bit better of a connection issue, or a bit better of a connection situation, although there is still some delay, I must admit. To whose connection it's coming from, I do not know. And it is perhaps me. I must also confess this is the first pay-per-view that I am doing since coming back home. And that has now changed my internet bandwidth from one person to six. So, not sure. And it all depends on who's using it when. So, I apologize in advance for that. The outside now, Ratluck leaving the ring. And I really hope we are not going to get back to this. All right. The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first in the ring, standing in the top left corner, from Columbus, Ohio, representing Kalisto, Aaron Phantom. And his opponent standing across the ring from him, representing Sin Cara. He is from New Jersey, Big Steph. Ding, ding, ding. All right, we are underway. They ferociously go charging at each other. Two very fast light heavyweights, one-on-one. Aaron striking first. So it's a 5-4 reversal advantage in favor of Aaron. A couple of kicks to his inside legs, and then a kick sweeping the legs from underneath Big Steph. Again, this is an uphill battle for Big Steph, but it's an opportunity for him to prove his worth. In Big Steph's EIF debut 3 years ago, he knocked off GTA Fan, an EIF Hall of Famer. There was great promise for Steph then. However, part-time appearances and interferences outside the realm of Xbox conflicted that. And so now Big Steph, years after that moment, is looking to kind of get some redemption, looking to get some opportunities here. He's already down to one reversal, and Aaron just continuing the onslaught of offense. Aaron has kept offense on two of the three reversal attempts from Big Steph. Remember, Kalisto going to be represented by Headshot Killa now after tonight. And Big Steph is out of reversals. And Aaron's down to three, and he's going to get some freebies now. Hurricane Ronald's delivered to Big Steph. Big Steph not being patient enough with those reversals. A standing moonsault connects for Aaron. Off the rope. Here comes Aaron. Off the other rope. Throwing all the weight. It's not much of Kalisto. But chest to chest connecting. And Aaron with a crucifix delivered to Big Steph. One taunt. That is not yet completed because of lag. And now it will. Aaron now picking up Steph again. Steph back to one reversal. Aaron with one signature. And I believe he was only hit one time. So Big Steph obviously having to be conservative. He's only got that one reversal. But Aaron has the ability to put him away now as he's getting closer. But if Big Steph ends up using that reversal and ends up going out, Aaron's going to probably have the freebie signature and the finisher. And Big Steph uses that one reversal. I thought my commentary would help him out. Clearly it did not. Kick to the back leg of Big Steph. Aaron is going to connect with the head scissor takedown. That's... Oh, wait a minute. Oh, wow. I didn't even realize that. The reversal that Big Steph had used was actually on the signature of Aaron. So kudos to Steph for picking his place there. I do give him some credit. Single leg breaker delivered. Obviously, it wasn't necessarily the best reversal, but it still does help him a little bit. Hasn't entirely stopped the bleeding, though. Aaron continues to maintain. It's just that one reversal advantage, but really what did Big Steph in was just using his reversals and firing them off in that first minute of this match as the Del Sol driver connects. And Salido Del Sol, the finisher, could be coming soon. Kick, Big Steph again using a reversal, and he gets Aaron to use one. Aaron will maintain offense all day, but now Aaron was stopped, and Big Steph, yeah, he's happy. There we go, one taunt for the big guy. Gotta love him. Aaron with a double reverse. Oh, wait a minute. But Aaron picking his spots right. Salido Del Sol connects into the pin combo. Is this it? One, two. And Aaron makes quick work of Big Steph two. No match is going the distance here tonight. A bunch of quick ones being rattled off. And a green bar connects for Aaron. Big Steph obviously had an uphill battle. And we now know why it didn't work out for him so well. So Aaron able to take advantage. All right, guys, and so with that, we are going to take a quick commercial break. But when we come back, we've got a triple threat match. It's our first of two multi-mans here tonight. You're watching Superstars Reborn live on the EIF Network. We'll be right back.